Listen to me carefully. Your life is in danger. There's a police officer right outside and she's coming to kill you. Whatever she tells you, don't trust her. Escape any way you can and meet me in an empty cabin in the woods just past the theater. Light the lantern in the creek to let me know you're there. Once you get there, I'll tell you everything.
My God, are you all right? I didn't think anyone would actually be in here. This is just sick. But don't worry, you're safe now. I'm Officer Matthews, but just call me Diane. You look pretty banged up. Go into the bathroom and give yourself a quick rinse, then I'll take you to the station.
Oh, hello there. I didn't mean to sneak up on you. I'm Vincenzo Salvatore. I run the town's library. Allow me to welcome you to Agony Creek, the famous gold mining town with the infamous tragedy. Founded in 1885 when the town founder Warren Walters struck it rich with the gold mines. A good man, but you'll find that everyone here has their own opinion of him in this town. But enough with the details. I must be off. Hope to see you around, old friend.
You made it. You must have a lot of questions, but we don't have a lot of time, so I'll make it quick. My name is Evelyn, and I want to help you. That cop that cornered you is bad news. She's done bad things to a lot of people. You have to stay away from her. But there's something much more dangerous out there. You might have seen a monster in a black cloak roaming around the town. There's something you have to know about it. It's...
It's coming for you. Both of you! You broke free from your shackles, but there's no escape. Not from me! Not from this town! There's a secret in this dilapidated city. It festers up to the surface from down below. Do you not remember it? You have one night to solve the riddle and discover the secret of Agony Creek. By night's end, this town will crumble under your feet, one way or the other.
Beautiful statue, don't you think? Erected in honor of Warren Walters, though some townsfolk lobbied to have it and any reference of the man torn down. The story goes that Warren Walters caused the explosion to take care of everyone so he could keep the gold for himself. But he died in the blast too. Now, supposedly Warren had a friend named Hank Briscoe who he killed. I'm thinking that's our monster in black. Meet me in the library near the town statue, and I'll show you everything I found. There is much to discuss.
There you are. I've been looking everywhere for you. Evelyn got to you, didn't she? Let me guess. She told you to light the lantern and meet her in that cabin and that she'd tell you everything? Evelyn is a con artist. She locks unsuspecting people up and makes them play her sick little games. She even plasters propaganda around to sell her story. I've been on her trail for a while now, but she's proven to be an apparition. Look, I want to get to the bottom of this as much as you do. That's why I need your help. Find a way to get into the graveyard of the church. I have a hunch that whatever's going on in this town has roots in there.
Over here.
We have to stop this monster before there's no one left. I managed to get away from him, but just barely. I have an idea, though. Believe it or not, that monster used to be human. And that's the key to defeating him. The more we know about him, the more power we have over him. First, you'll need to turn off the security cameras. There's a security panel on the outside wall of the bank in the alley. Better get going. Good luck.
Are you okay? You look like you've seen a ghost. Strange things are going on in this town. I'm gonna get to the bottom of it. Listen, I found something. There's a red brick wall beside the police station. I never thought much of it, but apparently the entrance to the famed Agony Creek gold mines is hidden behind it. I guess someone didn't want it being found. I'm sure that that's the secret to this whole mess. Find a way into the mines, and we can close this sad chapter in this town's history.
Do you remember me yet?
Thank you.
What about now? This has been a long time coming. You were my dearest friend. We were all good friends, even Hank. When we struck gold, Hank got more than just a twinkle in his eye. He wanted it all for himself. He's the one who set all the bombs that killed us, not me. He got out and started spreading lies around the town, trying to cover up what he did. He got away with it, too. As far as I know, he lived out the rest of his days a free man. After the explosion, he even came back and pried the rings off our charred fingers, just to pawn them off. These rings were a very important symbol of our friendship, for all of us. Return all of the rings to our departed bodies, and bring peace to us. So calming. Hank's betrayal was so traumatic that all of us blocked it from our memories. Our spirits were left to wander between life and death aimlessly. I was the first to remember what happened. It took me a long time of lingering in nothingness. And once I came to remember on my own, I lashed out at everything I could, terrorizing this poor town I once built to the point of ruin. Once I calmed down, I set out to allow each of you to remember on your own, just as I had. I wished to speed the process, so I created elaborate scenarios for each of you, one by one, like the one you've experienced tonight, to pull you down into the mines where it all began. And you're the last one, the final piece in this sad puzzle. I'm deeply sorry that I got you into all this. Behind me is a very large pile of explosives, much more than Hank used. What do you say we close these cursed mines forever and let our tortured spirits rest in peace? My friend, would you do the honors?